is Amy. Thanks so much for stopping by. Tonight I'm going to show you how I painted this particular design. I'm going to do that on one of my small canvases, which I've been doing here more recently with a lot of the designs I'm painting. And this is the Edge by Creative Mark Artist Products. I love these little canvases, as I state in every video I do with them. They're small, they're 6x6, 1.5 inches, and that might be backwards when it records, but 1.5 inches deep, and just a nice sturdy canvas. I guess that's probably why I like it so much, is that they are just really a nice quality canvas. Alright, so that's my sample, and I will be using Licorice, which is a Folk Art Enamel, Engine Red, also Folk Art Enamel, Moon Yellow, which is a multi-surface by Folk Art, my trusted Wicker White, which is a Folk Art Enamel, Citrus Green, the multi-surface paint. It's going to be different than the green that I used in my sample, which is the Fresh Cut Grass. For some reason, that paint is really thick and kind of gunky, gooey. And then Thicket, which is my base that I use most of the time for my late, well, basically all the time, because I love Thicket for some reason. It's my favorite leaf green. All right, so putting these aside, the brushes that I'm going to be using tonight are my number 12 one-stroke flat brush, and then I'm not sure on this one. It's a low Cornell shader, and it's small, so I don't know if it's like a 2 or something like that. And then my fine liner, my nail brush by Wistonia, which I absolutely love. It's amazing how easy it is to use and to get a nice look from, with it being such a thin little bristle brush. I'm not sure why that is, but I'll take it. It's fine with me. Alright, so I'm just getting some more paint out here. I probably should have done this sooner, but I want to just make sure I have enough to do this. Okay, so basically I am going to double load my brush. Let's see if I can get this done here. With the Engine Red and the Moon Yellow. And this is what it looks like when I double load. Like I said, I'm not precise, not particular, so you know, excuse me if it's not identical to what you've seen other people do, because I don't typically do my brush like other people do. Okay, so on this particular leaf petal, which I'm painting tonight, you're basically just going to do like a little dip and then go back up. And then I just keep turning my canvas. I'm going to go like this, kind of do like a little small dip, and then come back up. Some will have more of a dip than others. Like I said, it's fine. Basically, it can be a 5 or a 4 petal, or excuse me, not 4 petal, 5 or 6 petal flower. However you can fit the petals in. That really will determine. And right now I have 4. So I'm just going to do it as a 5 petal right now. I have in my sample, I did kind of overlap a couple of the bottom petals, which is fine. This one I'm going to start over here. And like I said, with my canvas being smaller than the paper that I was doing my sample on, you know, it may be arranged a little bit differently. But like I said, you can keep turning the canvas or your paper, whatever you're painting it on. Or if you're able to go both directions, that's fine too. Keep in mind, when I'm doing this, I actually am a lefty, so I may start in a different direction than what you do. Now this one I'm going to make it a 6-petal, and it will overlap a little bit, a couple of the petals, which is fine, perfectly fine. Alright, so then my next one, kind of did these to get started. My next one will be kind of over this direction. Again, as I mentioned before, this is going to be a little bit different since I don't have as much room on this little canvas. That's probably the downfall. I did have a bigger canvas that I had ordered a while back and did a few stripe designs on, and I was thinking that that's what these sizes were when I ordered them, but then I found out not so much. So it's okay. It truly is. It's all right. It'll work out. All right, so then I'm going to come over here and do another opened petaled one, or open flower, I should say. Just a real easy stroke. Just kind of a fun looking petal when you're done. Almost kind of reminds me of a heart. But obviously it's not a heart. But I love it. If you're new to my channel, please make sure that you hit the subscribe button. Hit the notification bell so that whenever I post a new video that you are getting the notifications so that you can view them. If you like this video, please make sure that you share it with your friends. And have any comments, I would love to hear from you. Just make sure that you subscribe so you're able to make those comments and hear back from me. Okay. Like I said, just kind of some fun little petals here. I'm going to do those. Do another set over here. It's fun. If you have any questions, please let me know. So I'm kind of going back and forth between some home decor projects that I'm doing or trying to do and trying to start sell to doing these. And then up at the top, I think I pretty much got what I wanted here. I'm going to come back up this direction. And again, with the layout on my sample, bigger paper, it's not going to look the same. But it's the general, you know, the general gist of it. And these are just going to be like partially open buds. And they're not going to be identical. So cute. If you like this video also, please make sure that you do give me a big thumbs up. And like I said, it's important to help me grow my channel so I can keep doing this, which I love to do. Love to bring you the videos. Alright, so now I'm going to switch over to my greens to work on the putting in the petals and the stems. Now on this one, I'm probably not going to do so much of like a stem like I did coming down on this one. Just because I think with the smallness of it, I'm just going to kind of make it like it's maybe just a arrangement of flowers going this direction. I put so many leaves in to fill it up that you'll get the gist of it. And with this, I'm just kind of turning it both directions, just making it blend into the little stem a little bit. Oops. And I'm going to turn it, do it to this one too, since they're like partially opened. And hopefully you can see what I'm doing. I really enjoy making the videos. I'm just gonna put these on here. They're fun. Definitely want to try to get them up on this one too without getting it touching that flower below it too much. And then doing it here. I'm still working on my water colors and my mandala dots. Just ordered some new tools today, so hopefully that will help me. Okay, on this one, I'm just going to do maybe a couple different types of leaves. Yeah, this green definitely moves better than the one I did in my sample. I think from the get-go there was something wrong with the paint. I don't know if it's old or what the deal was. I probably should have taken it back because it never did flow right. It kind of reminds me like these have wings. Oh, my imagination. Alright. They're going to fly away. I will have my products that I'm using linked in the video, or in the section below the video, I should say. I want that more filled in there. Why that's doing that. Yeah, it's kind of see-through. Alright, so let's keep going on with this. And like I said, I like a lot of leaves. If you're someone that doesn't, I always say, you know, use this as an idea, make it your own. You know, whatever you like or dislike, either add it or, and I'm just going to do the basic wiggle, leaf. It's okay to put them, you know, go over the top of your flowers. Again, on something like this, if you don't like to go wet on wet, maybe put a hair dryer on it. Or if you have a heat gun, you know, do the heat gun. I personally don't mind the colors. Kind of mixing a little bit. But again, if you do, then make it make it yours and put a hairdryer on it. Your call. But you can't be afraid to paint over wet on wet because of it. That makes sense. Alright, I am going to, let's do this. Add some of these leaves here instead of doing the con like I did up top. And again, too, on these leaves, you can switch them around where you have the lighter green on the outside. That's fine, too. You can actually rotate them so that some have the lighter green on the outside and some have the darker green on the outside. They don't all have to be going the same way. That's not necessary. Like I said, for the purpose of this video, with doing it on this small canvas, I'm not having enough, or not say enough room, but as much room to do it as I did on the actual sample that I put together. But I can also run down the edges here too. Put that in here. And just kind of fix that up a little bit. No, that's fine. Let's see here. Because I definitely want to get some more in the other direction too. And these wiggle leaves don't have to be, they don't all have to be a similar size. And you can make some smaller. You can actually have a smooth side if you want to do it that way on one side, or you can actually have, you know, smooth rounded sides on both. You don't have to wiggle. Again, if you have a favorite style of leaf you like to paint, by all means do it. I think this color combination is very pretty together with the red. The engine red and the yellow moon. It's very pretty. I'm just running these down the side. You don't have to, you can, or you can just leave it be with everything on the top. Personally, I think it gives it more interest to run it down the side a little bit. And I could have even taken some of the flower down the side, but I didn't. I'll just stick with the leaves. Like I said, I'm filling this up with leaves. I like leaves. But that's just, again, a matter of personal preference. I'm just kind of tapping it down the side. Makes it easier to get a nicer looking leaf when you're running it down the edge. I hope I'm getting this on the video here. Trying to. So my little canvases might be part of my restock, because I need to start moving some of this stuff so that I can actually keep buying to do videos with. It's the only problem you run into, I think, with doing this kind of stuff is, unless you're remodeling your home and you're going to be hanging all this stuff up, which I'm not, then it's a little difficult to store it all. Okay, that's going to come down here. Got in there. And I like these. Just like to mix them up a little bit. couple different style leaves. You can do more styles, you can do different colored leaves. You know, just don't be afraid to do that. It's just, it's whatever your interest is. Kind of blooped on that. Let's see here, what can I do to fix that? Let's see, maybe throw another leaf in there. Okay. So say when you do stuff like this, you kind of have to learn how to fix stuff if you don't like the way it's looking. I mean, you could possibly get, I don't want to say it, you could possibly wash it off, but that would probably require you washing all of it off, and I'm not certain that's something you really want to do at this point. If you're painting all this, I know I wouldn't want to. Take some of this paint up here. I like the thinner little vines. Clean up that a little bit. Alright, and I'm going to put something in here in the middle. Kind of fill up that little spot. And taking some red paint off while I'm doing this. Just so you know, I'm just going to kind of lightly go back over it here. Keep the color in there. Like that. I see another spot. I'm not happy. I might do this too down here. Like I said, I can get crazy with leaves, so bear with me. If you're not a leaf person, I'm sorry. But I am. All you have to do is just minimize it yourself. And I am going to add some of these little leaves right here. Yeah, I don't want to be too crazy with it. Like I said, you can go over the other leaves too and layer them. That's fine. Alright, let's take a look here and see what we have. I might do this just to get that, since I'm not doing it like a stem. I'm kind of take a little, I don't like a ton of paint on my brush. I feel like I can do a better job if I don't have a ton of paint on it. Okay, so right there we have that. And then what I'm going to do is take my smaller flat brush, go into my licorice, which is the black, and I'm going to tap in the centers. Now, hopefully you can see this. You know what? I'll pull it up here. You can see it better. And I'm just tapping with that brush. I actually, whoops, dipping it, and then I accidentally dipped it into my green. And then just kind of hitting it on here. And then I am going to just come around a little bit further down. For some reason it worked better on my sample. Not sure what's happening here. Okay, so I'm just tapping it around and putting it in there. I just don't want to have too much paint because then it kind of gets blobby. If that makes sense. Okay. And then I'm going to do that around this one, which I'll probably, because I can tell there's wet paint here and I'm not drying it, I'm going to end up with some yellow mixed in, which is fine. Like I said, that's perfectly fine. I hope you can see this. I get so concentrated on what I'm doing that sometimes I forget that I gotta make sure it's in the video screen here. And then I'm gonna come back over here and do it to this one. Something neat about having just the smaller flat brush, because you can use it to tap in the centers. I think this is pretty much the first time I've ever tapped in a center with it. But I thought, you know what? I'm gonna give it a try. See if it works. And go back to this one a little bit. And I will be tapping in some stuff into the center. Not stuff, but yellow. This one kind of has more of a grainy look to it. That's kind of a neat looking center though, I think. And this one I'm going to tap a little bit more. Get it a little bit more like I want it. That's what I say, you can just keep working on it until you get it to where you like it. And there you go. Now, with this little brush, I am going to dip it into the Yellow Moon. And then try to, once again, I'm sticking my fingers in everything. I am crazy when it comes to painting. Just tapping it in the center there. And you can use a different color if you want, but I thought the yellow looked good. I can use a different color for any of this stuff, honestly. Yeah, don't, you know, if you're practicing, don't go out and buy a bunch of new paint. If you have paint, you really can do these designs with any type of paint. Now, if you're painting on glass, that's a little bit different story because you do need to make sure you're using glass, you know, something that's appropriate for glass. Unless you're adding, you know, doing some kind of additive to it, which I have never done, so I don't really know that much about those, but I know there are additives you can put into paint for glass. Now it's going to have a little red in it. I don't really want the red. Just tap it in. You can make it bigger if you want or whatnot, or keep it small. And if you need to go back over it, you can do that too. Alright, the last step I'm going to do is using the Wicker White. And I have it right here. This is the fun part, I think, is when you come back in here and then you start doing like the little lines. Now with this, you can go like, you can go back like this. You can also wait too if you want. Wait till it dries a little bit. If you're like me, a lot of times I need something to kind of steady my hand. But just look how neat this brush. I mean, you can go either direction, add little things here, and just make it kind of fun and festive. I think, at least. I mean, I've struggled for years trying to do dot, you know, little veining dots and all that kind of stuff. And when I got this brush, it's like it makes it so much easier. Go either direction. It's probably one of my favorite new brushes that I've discovered. You know, you can just add as much as you want, as little as you want, up, down, all around, pull away. It's just awesome. Love this brush. I think you probably need to get some more, because I do like them so much. I can get kind of carried away with them. Just like anything else in life, I find something I like and I go mad. I'm gonna put them on here too, just to make it like, you know, hey, I'm in here, I'm gonna be coming out soon, I'm gonna be opening and you're gonna be seeing the whole flower here before too long. Yeah, even these little ones, I'm going to put them on. Even though they're small, they still have the middle in the center once it opens. Right? All right. So there you have it. Just a cute little design. I think it's very, very pretty. If you would leave a comment down below and let me know what you think, and I just stuck my finger in my paint. Good. Good job, Amy. Don't do what I do most of the time because you're probably going to make a mess, but no, just kidding. Anyways, if you like my videos, please give me a big thumbs up. If you haven't already subscribed, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it for the notifications whenever I do submit something new. And until the next video, have a good one.